Okay, we start this little recipe of mine today with 2 peeled potatoes. Incidentally, the better quality potatoes you use, the better the result will be. I personally use these. I actually really rate these potatoes. Albert Bartlett Reds. They're a little bit more expensive than the average spud, but they are excellent. They chip well, they're excellent chipping potatoes. You can boil them, mash them, they're really beautiful. I only buy that kind. Yeah, the rest are, you know, you can get so many different quality of potatoes, but these are consistently good. So anyway, we start off by grating these. And another one. Average size, largest potato. This is a brand new recipe for me. I kind of thought about doing it last night. I went to bed quite late, so I couldn't really be bothered to mess around too much with it. Surprisingly fast grating these potatoes. What I'm going to be doing is making some, hopefully, some nice, what do they call them? I don't know what you call them. Not pasties, that's evidently not what they are. Something like that, but I can't remember. The name eludes me. They're like small pancakes, actually, that's more what they are. Okay, we put that aside for a minute because I'm going to need this again shortly. That's our potato done. We just want something to pop that into this clean container. Okay, that's a potato, nicely grated. Then the next thing on our item is a good old onion. I need a decent knife for this. Okay. Right. A medium onion. One onion. Okay. That's it. Clear up as I go. Got a very small kitchen, so you kind of got to clear up behind you, otherwise you get knee deep in dirty dishes and things. So it's probably better to do it that way. Okay, I'm gonna. Oh, I've missed a bit of skin. Naughty me. Okay, get rid of that. I'm gonna do the same for the onion as I did with the potato. Make these patties. That's it, not pasties as I said earlier. I couldn't think of the name, it's patties. And you American people call them patties, we call them flapjacks or all sorts of names from depends what part of the country you're from as well. Fritters, all sorts of names. Alright, we're almost chew than what we want to do with the onion. Not quite as straightforward as a potato, obviously. Simply because the onion is in layers, in rings, whereas a potato is just solid all the way through. So these are a little bit more awkward to get right. Okay, got a little bit of onion left over, that's fine. Yeah, mostly water, these things. You're not left with a terrible lot of onion. Actually, you're getting the same amount, but of course it's being packed together like slush. That's as far as my fingers want to take that, so we'll leave that a little bit. I'll sort that out later. We'll pop that in there for now. Okay, that's that. Just be very mindful of your fingers when you're doing this. It's so easy to give yourself a slight injury. I'll pop that in with the potato. It's all going to be mixed up anyway, so I'm using this container, this ice cream container, as a mixing bowl. Obviously, use a mixing bowl if you have one. Next on the menu is cheese. This is best done straight out of the fridge, obviously. Keeps it more solid and up together. I don't mind a bit of onion on the cheese. It's all going to go down the same way anyway. The amount is completely arbitrary. If you like a lot of cheese, then grate a lot. If you don't like too much, then don't do too much. It's fairly intuitive. Yikes. I'm sorry, I haven't got my camera angle exactly positioned well, but that's the best I can do at the moment. I think that'll do. Yeah, that's fine there. Okay, that's the cheese done. Let's put it back in the old fridge. Right, now I'm going to leave the cheese out for a little while, because I've got to get the eggs sorted out. This, well, a couple of eggs, as I say. Now I do this, not everybody does this, and it's not very often you get an egg that's not very nice or even bad. But to avoid the possibility of knackering up several eggs with one bad one, what I do is I do them one at a time into the bowl. Then you can check. If you do get one that's a bit iffy, you're not going to spoil and waste what you've already put in there. That's the only reason I do that. Okay, now then, comes the nice bit. Move that out of the way. We shan't be needing that anymore. Not today. You can use your hands, you can use your fingers. I prefer to use a wooden spoon myself. Okay, so there's our ingredients, the eggs, the onion, and a patati. There you go, look at that, beautiful colour. Nicely mixed. There we go. That's our ingredients for our patties, pancakes, call them what you will. There you go, that's nicely mixed. That's beautiful. Now all we've got to do is put them in a skillet, frying pan. I am going to add the cheese now, I think. Yeah, I will. So the cheese can go in last. You can save a little bit of it to put on top for a sort of decoration. There's not a lot of point. I'm not going to do it that way. I'm just going to put the lot in. Because it's, as I say, it's all going to go down the same orifice anyway. Okay. That's that. At this stage, you can either add salt and pepper, which I am going to. A bit of salt. That's it. And a little bit of pepper. I'm going to use my black pepper for this. It's up to you what kind of pepper you use, obviously. Here we are. A bit of pepper. Again, just give it a blend it in, as they say. And that is our mixture ready for cooking. Then you just get a spoonful, maybe a couple of spoonfuls, to make a nice large breakfast patty. Just shape it, use your spoon, so you've got something like a largish beef burger shaped, sized thing in your pan. As I said, just shape it to combine it together. The eggs will work to do just that, to keep it in shape. It'll be interesting to see what this is like. I'm actually quite looking forward to it, folks. We'll see. We'll see. I'm keeping the camera running because it doesn't make a lot of sense not to. Just keep switching it on and off, it's better just left on, and I can edit it down afterwards. One plate. Well, I must admit, it smells beautiful. It really does. Of course, what it tastes like is a completely different thing. Yep, that looks fine. That looks fine. Okay, I'm going to stop proceedings there. It's going to... It's what I would say is slightly overcooked, but bearing in mind this is a complete new thing that I'm doing. I will give an honest appraisal of what this is like. Okay. Just a little bit on the edge because it's going to be really, really hot. Mmm. Mmm. I'll tell you what, that is nice. Everything's cooked properly. Mmm. That is nice and savoury. I would say that was about a quarter of an inch thick. You don't want them too thick. Otherwise, the cooking is going to increase that exponentially. Plus,
the chances of it burning on the outside have become greater. So the thinner you can do them within a sensible ratio, the better. That, folks, is really nice. I kid you not.